Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm right. Maybe I just don't know. Will I fall in love and never have to worry that I'm falling all alone? Maybe it's true. Just born to be free. Maybe it's true. I was just born to be free.
Goodbye. but on my hand. On the big old plane and fly to a foreign land. Shirley Rose, a fancy cook, say, honey, you could take your pick. That be my kind, but it ain't gonna do the trick. Give a little love. This, you can be some big honk, handsome, dark and tall. Talk to me in foreign tongues with a southern drawl. But be a man, of course I am. Wear a pointed hat. I don't care how you look, cause that ain't where it's at. Give a little love, a little squeeze, a little kiss. Give a little hug. Knock off your feet. Sweet talk and big blue eyes make a poor heart skip a beat. Drive you wild with a smile and then they'll treat you cruel. I'm gonna fall for that cause mama didn't raise no fool. Give a little love, a little squeeze and a little kiss. Give a little hurt.
There. To a heart that's true. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't want no other love, baby, it's just you I'm. Gentlemen, the Jordanaires. Baby, I can't admit something I might have said. Please let's forget the past, 'cause future looks bright ahead. Don't be cruel to hope that's true. I don't want no other love, baby, it's just you I'm. Well, I don't stop thinking of me. Don't make me feel the sweat. Come on over here and love me. Well, you know what I want to say. Don't be cruel to hope that's true. Why should we be apart? I really better love you, baby. Cause my well, let's walk up to the preacher. That's true. I don't want no other love, baby, it's just you I'm thinking of. Don't be cruel to hope that's true. Don't be cruel to hope that's true.
The Jordanaires.
Are you characters always like this? Tonight is sort of a celebration, I think, of love, laughter, music, and life. And I've got a couple of girls down here that are looking at me like, what are you wearing? This is my party dress. I can see you talking about me. Winona and I name all of our outfits. This is my party dress, and I broke into the Country Music Hall of Fame to get this out for tonight, because this is a party. But I mean, did you guys honestly think that somebody that would wear an outfit like this would just, like, disappear to a farm without throwing some kind of a blowout bash? Well, I think Winona and I love country music more right this minute than we did the day we discovered it, because you all have allowed us the last 8 years to not only heal our relationship and become best friends, but I think you quite possibly may have saved my life. So this is a thank you appreciation party for your love and prayerful support during the farewell tour. I think music allows us to express emotions sometimes that words just can't define. I figured that out when I wrote this next song. I believe that music is the breath of God. I think it's a healer.
Heal my mind.
had a dream about me and you. Had a dream and I woke up crying. Well, I can try, but I just can't stop. And the time's dragging by tick tock. Oh, my heart, it just can't love no one but you. But I'm high and dry and lonely. I'm as lonesome as can be. And I stay. Grandma, oh, my heart just can't love no one but you. Oh, my but you. Had a dream about you, baby. Had a dream about me and you. Had a dream and I woke up crying. Well, I can try, but I just can't stop. And the time's dragging by tick tock. Oh, my heart just can't love no one but you,
Mr. Steve Sheehan.
Oh, my heart, it just can't love no one but you.
The pride and joy of New Bedford, Massachusetts.
Okay, girls, I want to tell you something. I want to tell you one thing. My mama tried to warn me, so I'm going to say it one more time. Men, all you men out there, stand up. Girls, you can't live with them. No, you can't live with them. Now, all y'all sit down. His letter came this morning, C-O-D. Says he's found somebody who reminds him of me. He says he needed some space. That might be the case. He wasn't even man enough to tell me to my face. I got the romping, stomping,
bad news, the love. He stole my money. He stole my time. He stole my heart. Honey, he really crossed that line. Sent out a baby, a major felony. Go tell that thief of hearts to bring it on back to me. I got the wrong man, stomping, bad news to lose. But come tonight,
from beautiful Cleveland, Ohio.
Well, men are full of trouble. Girl, that ain't nothing new. We ain't found nothing better. And until the day we do, sister, friends, be wise. Just realize. Stay away from ones who'll do you wrong and tell you lies. They'll give you the wrong man. Bad news blue. That's right, they'll give you the wrong thing, stomping, bad news.
I guess Winona and I are sort of a director's nightmare because we just threw this this song and the next song in. Winona and I were totally intimidated by tonight because this is very cool, by the way, looking out, and I see all these people whose names I actually know from all 50 states sitting out here. But I have to tell you all that for the last week, this almost was not a show tonight. For the last week, there's a terrible flu going around, and my husband and my other daughter, Ashley, were quarantined to the farm, and I've been living in a little motel by myself. And Winona, literally 3 days ago, had absolutely no voice. And I mean no voice. She's been over at Vanderbilt in the hospital with the doctors.
But isn't tonight a glorious night? We have to... We have to realize sometimes that
You know, we're human. I think Mom and I have a long time felt like hope sellers. You know, we get out there on life's highway and we live on that bus and we eat in hotels, and it's a crazy lifestyle, but the one thing that keeps us going is you guys, because it's that one-on-one human relationship. And I just want you all to know that I've been so nervous I didn't really know what to say tonight. I mean, what can you say about the last 8 years that hasn't already been said? But we want you to know that you guys, we will never forget you. And I want to say to my dear mother, she is my light. She is the reason that I can go on, because she is healed. She is in remission, and she's here tonight. I love you, and you will always be my favorite partner.
Well, that's exactly why we pulled out something for us to sit on, because Winona and I are not used to this. This is a big, fat, hairy deal. You know, this big mega director named Lou Horowitz, who is just, we've just about given him a coronary, I guess. And we have a brand new stage tonight. We have different lights. We didn't know what we were doing. And last night, Winona and I were under the most pressure we've ever been under in our life, which is saying a whole lot. And she hadn't spoken a word in 3 days.
We were Imagine just, that.
We were kind of enjoyed parts of it, but the reason I'm saying this is last night, we left here about a minute after midnight, so it was technically December 4th, and it started to snow outside, and I didn't think we had a show tonight. I didn't think I was going to get to...
It was one of the saddest nights of my life, I think.
We were just feeling totally overwhelmed by all this, because we're just a couple of little redheaded girls from a small town in Kentucky, and we just don't... I mean, I just looked over and saw Reba McEntire sitting over here. And I see Emmy Lou Harris, and, you know, all these... I see Randy over here and all these idols of ours. And basically, all Winona and I know is sitting in a little living room or being on the back porch, you know, and just singing, and just the two of us. So last night as I was leaving, there were a bunch of people standing out in the snow and the cold after midnight that had waited to say some things to me. And it was the darkest hour of my life, and as I rolled down the window, they leaned in, and one of you girls out right here said that we love you and we feel like you're one of our family. And then after that, the tide changed. We decided we had to do this tonight. And the reason I love being on stage is that when I feel these lights, I just imagine it's rays from heaven.
And you're the queen of everything.
Well, I guess that makes you the jewel in my crown, my dear, and little Ashley and Larry, whom I haven't even touched or seen all week, are sitting over here. It's always been me, Winona, and Ashley, the three musketeers, just us against the world. But now we've got Larry, my Prince Charming, the unseen hero in this little family. Nobody's been able to hug me for a week because of my fragile health. They were afraid I'd get that flu. And right now, I just feel like there's this big hug going on. And I just wanted to do this song, Guardian Angels, because the Bible tells us they're real. And they're all around us right now.
A 100-year-old photograph stares out from a frame, and if you look real close, you'll see our eyes are just the same. I've never met them face to face, but I still know them well from the stories of my dear grandma tell. Elijah was a farmer. He knew how to make things grow. And Fanny vowed she'd follow him wherever he would go. As things turned out, they never left their small Kentucky farm, but he kept her fed. She kept him warm. They're my guardian angels. I know they can see every step I take. They are watching over me. Might not know where I'm going, but I'm sure where I come from. They're my guardian angels, and I'm their special one. Sometimes when I'm tired, I feel glad to take my arm. He says, keep on going hard work, never did a body harm. When I'm really troubled and I don't know what to do, and he whispers, just do your best, we're awful proud of you. They're my guardian angels. I know they can see every step I take. They are watching over me. Might not know where I'm going, but I'm sure where I come from. They're my guardian angels. They're special one. 100-year-old photograph stares out from a frame, and if you look real close, you'll see our eyes are just the same.
Bless you guys.
Man, I wish tonight would never end. Thank you.
She calls me the queen of everything. I left my tiara and my scepter out on the bus. If I had it with me, I'd just go bing and freeze this moment in time. You know, I wrote that song about my great-great-grandparents who lived a long time ago back in Kentucky, and never in a million years thought that somebody like us would get a chance to meet so many good people. But on the spur of the moment, I called up the man who took us out of the living room, around the kitchen table, and put us on the radio. This is Mr. Brent Mayer, the man who discovered us. Isn't he cute? You're looking handsome and bulletproof. What was it, 82? I was working as a nurse in a little country hospital, and Winona was still in high school. I took care of his daughter and just fell in love with the whole family. And he started coming by our farm, listening to us. I've never asked you this before, but I've always wondered, what in the world do you thought about these two redheaded boogie-woogie babes from Mars? I hope it's good.
I've been dying to say this for years. I listened to that tape, and it absolutely killed me. The little cassette she gave me. But I gotta tell you, it wasn't really your singing. Not that it wasn't good. Actually, it was more than good. It was great. But what really got me was just the wacky sense of humor. I mean, I'm telling you. Yeah, you. I don't know. They always had that. They always had just a sensational sense of humor, imagination, and but the real hook was a wonderful heart. And that was the deal.
Who says you can't combine business with pleasure? And then he brought over one of his best friends, the man who would become our spiritual mentor and who makes all those signature licks on all the Judd records, Mr. Don Potter. This was a musical partnership made in heaven, I think. They gave us a studio and a creative environment in which to grow. We needed a lot of weeding, didn't we?
I need to recall this thing. It may be embarrassing for the moment, but there was a small farm on Del Rio Pike near Franklin, Tennessee. There was a skunk sleeping under the front porch, and you remember this, don't you? And I came in on a Saturday afternoon with Brent, and he said, you need to hear these girls. You just need to hear these girls. And I came in, I thought it would be just your average, you know, listen to a couple people sing, you know, what the heck. Play a little guitar. And there they were with full war paint, ready to do a gig. And I just, there we are in the kitchen. I said, yeah, okay. This looks great.
This is normal.
And they started to sing. And I just felt the pleasure of the Lord. That's the only thing I could remind. I just said, that just is great, you know. And I felt to myself, the first thing that came over me is I need to do whatever I can, whatever that costs me, whatever that means. I didn't have much to give, but whatever that cost, I need to dedicate it to doing my best.
Makes you realize dreams do come true. You know, we used to be just like you guys out there, crazy. Well, we still are, actually, and I'm real thankful that country music has given us a chance to be ourselves. I mean, I know that a lot of the other country music artists have said this, but we really feel like we've been able to just sing our songs. I mean, you guys have really taken us into your hearts, and that means a lot to us because we didn't know any other way. Little did we know back then that this would be put on a record. This was the first song we ever learned together.
I think it was, 1979? We learned this to sing to my mom. We'd kind of fallen on hard times, didn't have any bucks to buy her a gift. My mom's sitting right over here. The original Judd. But we learned this song to sing to her for Mother's Day. And I think our mothers give us the two greatest gifts, life, and she gave me a Christian home.
One day a mother come to a prison to see an erring but precious son. She told the warden how much she loved him. It did not matter what he had done. She did not bring to pardon. She brought no silver, no pomp nor style
to see.
It was a halo sent down from heaven's the sweetest gift, a mother's smile. She left a smile you can remember. She's gone to heaven from heartaches free. Them bars around you will never change her. You was her baby and there will be. She did not bring to him her all of pardon. She brought no silver, no pomp nor style. It was a halo sent down from heaven, the sweetest gift, a mother's smile. It was a halo sent down from heaven's sweetest gift a mother's smile.
Thank you.
Excuse me, United States of America, but would anybody out there care to do a little bit of rocking with the rhythm? My goodness, you're a rowdy bunch.
Sitting in the boat swing, listening to the live rain, baby, on the cheek, baby, just a minute, yeah. Rockin' with the rhythm of the rain. Slide on over, bear my home closer. Move it to the boat, just swaying like a slow train. Rockin' with the rhythm of the rain. So let the breeze keep blowing. Only tenderness can find. women like men to love them through the blues sometimes. If her days all run the same, and she says she thinks she needs a change, baby, oh baby, got the blues. And if she says she's just a wife,
John Blazer.
Mercy on me. still got it. Woo! Carl Perkins. He was the first man to play electric guitar on a Judd record. Isn't that cool? Ever since the day that time began, there's been this thing between a woman and a man. Well, I don't know, but I do believe it started in the garden with Adam and Eve. Samson and Delilah have their flame, just cut his hair and clipped his wings. It don't matter how the story's told, his love station can't control.
Let me tell you about the earth, about the moon and the stars above. It's what we've all been dreaming of. Let me tell you about love.
Bonaparte and Josephine, I believe they had a pretty good scene. Till she said, Bonnie, go with you. And that's when they met this Waterloo.
Julie Bike and Romeo fell in love and stole the show.
I know they are history, but there ain't been nothing like you and me.
Let me tell you about the world, about the moon and the stars above. It's what we've all been dreaming of. Tell you about love. Tell you about love.
Solomon, he was mighty wise, but Sheba, she don't caught his eye. The world would be in dreadful fix if it wasn't for the love between cats and chicks. This world wouldn't amount to much without a hug and kiss and tender touch.
Let me tell you.
Men in the whole world. We want to dedicate this entire show to a man that Winona and I call the third Judd. We wouldn't be standing here right now. We call him Mr. Big, the Chief Big Ideas, the King of Think, our manager, Mr. Ken Stiltz.
Thank you.
Love is a man and he's mine. Love is alive and at a breakfast table every day of the week. Love is alive and it grows every day at night, even in our sleep. Love is alive and it's made a happy woman out of me. Oh, love is alive.
Good God, time to lose. Thank you.
Look at here. It is a man's world, girls. We've got six hairy-legged ornery boys that we have been living with for 8 years. I mean, traveling on buses together, bad motels, even worse, truck stop food, missed planes. But you know what? It's been a blast, hasn't it, baby? This guy is Mike Weber. He's out of Roanoke, Virginia, and he's the oldest Judd boy. I should have checked my water. He might put his teeth in it over there. Isn't he a long, tall drink of water? You know, you could go naked and drink you a little tomato juice and pose as a thermometer at Halloween, I think. But, I mean, we've been cooped up on life's highways for 8 years with these guys. Oh, it's a dirty job, honey, but somebody's got to do it. Lots of miles and memories, hey.
Remember when you used to wear all that spandex and we used to dance all night long? Yeah.
He's talking about me and Winona going out dancing with all the cowboys. I won't tell if you won't. Ladies and gentlemen, the best musical pals we ever had in our whole life, the fabulous Judd Boys.
Still playing and promises I made. Were just words I was saying. I was playing you for a fool, breaking love's precious rule. Now did you so wrong? Guess you knew all along. And I had my boss lie for me to say I was working. Well, that's about to be today. But baby, now I see I was only cheating me. Before you go, I just want you to know. Well, I've had a change of heart. Change of heart. I see where I put you through, and I'll make it up to you. I've had a change of heart. I've just got to show you how differently I feel. That I care. My love is real, but my past will forever haunt me if you say you don't want me. And I'm down on my knees, and I'm begging you, please, won't you have a change of heart? Change of heart. I see when I put you through, and I'll make it up to you. Please have a change of heart. Oh, please have a change of heart.
La 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 la
I can't believe that tonight has finally been here. I feel like this whole year I've been trying to figure out what I was going to say tonight. And I really can't talk, but I got in the mood this morning to try to sing. I haven't sung for 2 days, and nothing came out. And I thought, oh, Lord, it's not going to happen. But the one thing that's perfect tonight is that you guys are out there sharing this with us. I couldn't find my shoes. I got the wrong boots on. I don't like the way my hair looked tonight. But I got my mom, and I got you guys. And that's all that matters right now. Thank you.
I think the most profound things are the most inexpressible anyway. The doctor said that, by the way, I see my friend Larry Gatlin over there. I called him in the middle of the night 3 nights ago and said, Larry, brother, we need your voice, doctor. Winona can't sing. Nothing would come out. And this doctor opened up in the middle of the night at midnight and saw Winona and said, you know why she couldn't sing?
And then Zimmerman put it in USA Today. Yeah. We couldn't keep it secret. So
the doctor said that Winona couldn't sing
people called
because she
canceled.
Didn't want tonight to happen. Because she didn't want to lose me, but you're not going to lose me.
Mom's going to be my road manager.
One thing that we've learned this whole year is that life is embrace and release. Embrace and release. You teach what you want to learn. And this is our last professional embrace. This is our last song together. And I want you to know that the deepest source of your identity is not being a Judd. It's not being Hurricane Winona or even my daughter. The deepest source of your identity is the Lord. I kind of feel like I've been Cinderella gone to the ball for the last 8 years. But now the hour is drawing nigh. I'm going to go home with my Prince Charming. And tonight is not my going away party. I'm not going anywhere. You're the one that's going places. This is your going away party. Just spread your wings and fly. And go towards the light, baby. Go towards the light.
Grandpa,
tell me about the good old days. Sometimes it feels like this world's gone crazy. Grandpa, take me back to yesterday, when the line between right and wrong didn't seem so easy. Did lovers really fall in love to stay? Would stand beside each other and come what may? Is a promise really something people kept? Not just something they would say. Grandma,
just don't know. And Grandpa,
let's wander back to the past
and paint me the picture of long ago.
I want y'all to sing it. This wonderful, wonderful night. Good night.
and gladly walk across the desert with no shoes upon my feet to share with you the last bite of bread I had to eat. I would swim out to save you in your sea of broken dreams. When all your hopes are sinking, let me show you what love means. Love can build a bridge between your heart and mine. Love time. I would whisper love so loudly every heart could understand, that love and only love can join the tribes of man. I would give my heart's desire so that you might see. The first step is to realize that it all begins with you and me. Love can build a bridge.
So enormously blessed to have gotten to travel all over this great country these last 8 years. And you all are what inspired me to write this song.
Love and only love
I believe in the power of love. And I believe there is always hope.
It's been